Hello guys, today I'll be showing you guys how to repair your broken headset. The microphone is bad, so I'm going to be changing the complete wire. Before I continue with the fixing, I'll show you guys the instruments you need. You need a soldering iron, a soldering lead, an insulator tape, and also an aux cord. Okay, I already unscrewed this and I'll be removing the cover. This is the microphone that got spoiled. This is the wire. I'll be changing this wire. I'm going to be removing the wire now from the headset. I'll be putting the new wire back inside the headset. After putting it inside, I need to strip off the wire naked. This is yellow, blue, and red color. I'll have to fast forward this, I'm sure. It won't be hard to strip the wire naked. It's to just save yourself of buying a new headset. It's better to just buy a aux cord for nothing more than $1, not even up to $1. You fix your headset and everything is back to normal. Though I did not put a... Though I won't be using the microphone, it will just be headset with no microphone right now, because the aux cord does not come with the microphone. Mostly I think I don't really need a microphone actually. I'm putting more solder on the wire itself, just to prepare it for soldering it on the headset itself. I need to tie this wire so that I will be tying this wire to secure it from pulling out. That's what I'm doing right now. Though the aux cord I bought is kind of fat small, so it's kind of hard to tie, but it still works for me because I just want a good cable. I don't want something that will fix and it will in a few months or something. So like I said, the colors are for different functions. That's the cable that came from the second speaker of the headset. Cable has different color to the red, so this is very easy join. All you need to do is to just join the same color together. Now I'm joining the red to the red of the second, the red of the second speaker of the headset. I'm joining to the red from the cable itself. I'm going to solder this so it will be firmly attached. I and you just like doing this so that it won't remove, you can just wind them together and tape it if you like. But I like to put solder so to just make it firm. In this way, I'll be guaranteed there's a good contact. So I joined the red to the red from the cable, and I'm joining the yellow, which is the ground, from the cable itself to the other wire that came from the second speaker. Now I'm going to, after this, I'm going to solder this to the main speaker itself, because this is the main speaker that has the solder, which I'm going to be soldering it to. Now I'm going to solder the ground to the ground part of the main speaker. So now I'll be soldering the other blue color wire that came from the main cable itself to the second part of the main speaker, because the main speaker has two parts where you solder the blue color wire to. As you can see, this is the blue wire soldered to the main speaker, and the yellow, which is the ground, basically the ground coming from the second speaker and the ground from the main wire, together with the second, with the ground part on the main speaker itself, have soldered all together. And also the blue wire from the main cable, I've soldered it to the second soldering part on the main speaker itself. I will add more solder to this to have a good contact. After adding the solder, and as you can see the glue, everything is firmly attached. I'm going to tape the other wire, which is the red, which is joined to the red cable itself, which comes from the second part of the speaker. Because if you don't do this, if it touches, then you won't have a good connection. So this is what I've done, and it's all looking well soldered. And you should make sure the wires are not touching each other, because that's exactly what I've done. Putting the tape over the other wire, which I didn't solder to the main speaker. So I'm going to be putting this back now. Okay, I need to adjust this way, because also make sure you don't make this too long. When you'll be putting it back, it will be difficult. It's better to adjust it right here. Closing it back, I'll unscrew this. As you can see, I'm double checking just to be sure nothing is. It well, sitting well, it will be a good choice, you know, because this kind of aux cable will last you better than a thin one. place the foam back on it. So the foam is very easy to put. Just put the parts, then turn it around. It's kind of elastic, so you can try to put it small, but be careful not to pull it too much because it can tear. After this, I'll plug it into a fan just to check if everything is in place, if everything is well fixed. All right. The sun coming out of the headset itself. That's just how to fix your headset that is having a broken microphone. The wire, the mouth of the wire, it's no more good. It's not fitting. So please subscribe and give a thumbs up. If you have any comments, you can drop section below.